last year they were going to do a re-release of that in theaters, select theaters. One of them was downtown AMC, and I was super excited, and then they canceled it because of the pandemic. I was a little bummed out by that. I was like, So, yeah. Great animated films, yep. I mean, Under the Red Hood, also really, really good, if you haven't seen it. Some of the recent ones, I've been a little hit and miss for me, personally. DC animated being what they are. I am very curious though about the Batman movie with what's it doing? What's his name? Please do not disturb the keepers. I don't want to say Sparkle Twilight Man because that just seems like it takes away what he actually does. but he was also in Harry Potter. Robert Pattinson, yes. Because the man can act. We know this. It just, Twilight was, okay, here's money. Okay, go. Now you can do anything you want. You have the wealth behind you. Pick any project you know, have a passion for. Go with it. Also, taking the Riddler and turning him into a serial killer, I'm admittedly kind of curious about that. Because it does make sense to have him go that direction. Never it made sense for me to have him be like a brawler, beastie, like Bane character they did one of the portrayals, but yeah. Killing Joke, Death in the Family were both good. I'm gonna say this. That is a Krogan statue. What the hell is a Krogan statue doing in an... That's really weird to have a Krogan statue right there. I never noticed that. I'm gonna say this. I don't like Killing Joke. Yeah. Like, I've read the comic, I've watched the animated movie. In both situations, I didn't like it. Just, I clean up did not like either. Like, I didn't think it captured who Bruce was or Batman. Which is weird because I know everyone's like, oh, it's so good. I'm like, also felt like it, the creator of it didn't understand who Joker was as a character. And it just, it never, Joker was always about, like, he wants to get under Bruce's skin. He wants to get under Batman's skin, but there's a joke to it. There's always a punchline. There's always something there, a gag, right? And as demented as it is, but there's always just that.
Greetings and welcome to the Presidio.
But it felt like low-level thought.
A virtual guide throughout this level of the Citadel space station.
And it never clicked with me. So, Lady Twilight vampires don't sparkle. I feel like I'm gonna date myself when I say this, but I have gray hairs now, so it doesn't matter. Well, I mean, I've had gray hair since I was 11, but doesn't matter. One of my favorite interpretations of vampires is actually Interview with the Vampire. Tom Cruise as Lestat is creepy, unsettling, and disturbing. Like, you aren't too sure whether you're dealing with somebody who's going to hug you or assault you. And has a way of just getting under your skin in, like, almost a way that, like, if they had at that time had asked, instead of Jack Nicholson, which I did love his interpretation Joker, had asked Tom Cruise to be Joker, I think you would have seen something similar to, like, Heath Ledger's interpretation. Just, yeah. Cruise plays himself. I guess. It's weird. The little girl in Interview with a Vampire, that's MJ. From the Sam Raimi movies.
What does that mean?
I am a fully interactive virtual intelligence, programmed to provide spontaneous guidance at predetermined locations of interest throughout this level of the Citadel. I may also be contacted through any of the Presidium VI terminals.
Were her eyes ever that disturbing? Because I remember her, like, you go up to her, you get information, right? She's your virtual guide. Always? Okay, because that's just... I don't know why, like, why add the veins to the eyes? Robert De Niro's Frankenstein was good. Robert De Niro's Frankenstein. Wait, was Robert De Niro in a... I remember the Mary Shelley's Frankenstein movie in like late 80s, early 90s. Was, is that the, Red, is that the one you're talking about?
Give me the tour.
Welcome to.
Because now I'm curious, like Robert De Niro in Frankenstein. That makes me wonder.
Here in the financial district, a number of businesses offer various goods and services to their exclusive clientele.
That's.
The statue was, you see before
wait,
you
who?
Was commissioned to what? Honor the Krogan soldiers who gave their lives to protect Citadel space during the Rachni Wars.
That's why
in
there's
the
a statue.
Aftermath
okay.
Of the Krogan rebellions, several embassies petitioned to have the statue removed. However, this motion was eventually quashed by the council.
Okay, hold on.
That's all for now.
Thank you for using.
I gotta look this up real quick. Because I remember, the type in movie, because it's a very specific. Son? Biscuit. Wait! He was the monster. I feel like I'm gonna have to. Yeah, no, I Bram Stoker's Dracula is one of my personal like favorite movies. But I was never allowed as a kid to watch Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. Bram Stoker's Dracula was like okay, I guess. Gary Oldman. Keanu Reeves, that was one of his, that British accent, like, all over the place, but it was okay, it was just great having him in it, but the effects in that movie were all done old school, wasn't really a whole lot of, like, to use CGI, right, they had to come up with very clever and unique ways. And it's one of those, like, the director at the time wanted to make sure that everything was, like, shot in scene. Makes it even trickier. And he just wanted to capture that older aesthetic. And it worked out really, really, really well. Like, really, really well. Yeah, I completely spaced. Yeah. I didn't know he played the monster. I'm sorry. Consort Chambers? I just... For science, I need to check this out.
Welcome. I am Nalina. I don't recognize you as one of our expected clients today. Would you like me to see when the consort will be able to meet with you?
Do I need an appointment?
Can I just go in?
I'm afraid not. Yeah, you must understand there are many who seek the consort services. But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
What is the consort? What does she do?
It's difficult to explain. She's many things to many people, and something different for each. Some seek her for advice, some for entertainment. Others
yeah, I was really
got it,
like...
Most of the time, our clients won't realize.
He seems to gravitate towards like.
Until after she has provided it.
I don't
want
to say techno. Well, I guess it is. Future techno movies, right? Where just technology is integrating in a person or is integrating in our lives in a very like different way. And I remember Johnny Mnemonic. That actually was a good movie. Really is. It actually also was kind of scary when you think about it. Like, if that ever happens down the road, right? people are walking data banks. And then you just, all right, well, client's going to give me $2.5 million. I guess I don't need my childhood. I'll delete that part. There you go. Or worse, I'll try to keep it and hold on to the data as it's like slowly causing an aneurysm.
You make her sound like some kind of oracle.
No, not in the usual sense. She's merely a woman. A woman with remarkable compassion.
It was.
And a generous
and to be honest, it's kind of getting
I
relevant now.
I suggest you make an appointment and see for yourself.
Can't I just go in?
But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
Every
Commander Shepard, with the Alliance Navy.
Excellent.
Jane
you should hear something
Shepard.
In 3 or 4 months.
Oh.
Nobody's worth that much of a wait.
Well, that's not for me to judge. I have your name and you'll be contacted. Is there anything else?
I think I'm done here.
Oh, well, I hope you'll return again in the future. We always enjoy seeing new clients.
Nalina.
Yes, Shaira?
Send the commander up to see me. I wish to speak with her.
Yes, of course, mistress.
That camera angle.
It appears the consort has taken notice.
Boobas!
She'd like to meet with
Maybe
you.
Maybe later.
If I have time, I'll speak with her.
Well, don't wait too long. I wouldn't want you to miss this opportunity.
She's like so excited. She's like, are you ready for a booty call? Let's go get that booty call. I'd like to believe it's just, you know, companionship.
You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
Hey, I know the voice actor. Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Right. Free summer. Yep. Legend, if you will. Like, pretty much almost anybody's childhood. Yeah. Everywhere, and I love it. Amazing. I was a little bummed out. So there was a reunion of sorts, and they had Kree on there, and she didn't get a whole chance like to talk, and I was kind of bummed out because I wanted to hear her opinion on a few things for like different roles she had, how she handled the roles, like, because she's in everything.
That is close enough, Commander. I've heard a great many things about
it. It is the pandemic. 6 feet, Chad. 6 feet. Now wear your mask. 6 feet. Checking up on me?
I don't like people spying on me.
I apologize, Commander. I make it my business to know when important people arrive on the station. Many of them become clients. But that is not
You know what I just remembered,
you.
Though?
I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Okay, so as I'm looking at the Asari right here, they have a thing where they have, in their culture, if an Asari has a baby with another Asari, there's a chance to have a, like, life-sucking bust baby. Right? Something like that? Right? Is it Mass Effect 2 or 3 where, like, if you kill the Sentinel woman, the mother, then you get the, like, her daughter shows up, right? Vampires, basically. Yes, vampires. Like, am I misremembering this? I'm pretty sure this is right, right? Because I just realized, if we're going Renegade, that means that we're going to have a vampire in our party at some point. Samara, there we go. Morinth.
Get to the point.
I have a friend, Septimus, a retired Turian general. I won't discuss the details, but he wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he spends his days in Korra's den, drinking and spreading lies about me. If you would speak to him as a fellow soldier, I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
Right, are we thinking old school Battlestar or sci-fi Battlestar? Because actually, I rewatched the remake Battlestar Galactica. It still holds up, with, I would say, that exception to that weird ending. Still holds up. That and my surprise. I started rewatching Stargate Atlantis because Jason Momoa, big fan. And a few of the other characters in there, real good. Still really, really good.
What happened between you?
I respect his privacy too much to go into the details. If he wishes to tell you what happened, that is his prerogative.
Especially, out of the blue, there's a Stargate game coming out. Just out of the blue. I don't know why. I don't know how. But there's a Stargate game being made. I don't know if it's coming to mobile or PC, but it's being made. And it's releasing later this year. So I was like, I saw the trailer to it. I was like, oh, the top down, like isometric, almost Diablo-esque game. I was like, oh, okay. I was like, man, I haven't seen Stargate in a while. I rewatched the original movie, which also really good. James Spader, Kurt Russell, which always Kurt Russell's always a treat to watch. Badass. Tango and Cash. Tango.
Why should I bother to help your friend?
Could it be I was wrong about you, Commander? Are you certain you will not aid me in this?
I love how you've ever seen the behind the scenes to Stargate. How they pulled off the activation of the gate, knowing that there's no CGI. Like, there is, but it's, they only use like CGI in between. That effect there is actually not CGI. That's a real effect that they just upscaled. And it's, yeah. Seen original Stargate movie like 20 times. I remember watching that in the theaters for the very first time, and as good. I got excited for the TV show, and then I only watched a little bit. I didn't really connect to it. My best friend did, but then Atlantis came around, and I was like, hooked on Atlantis, like just completely hooked on it. I loved like the vampire monsters. I love the snarky kind of semi-asshole doctor.
Goodbye, Shayera.
Oh, wait, did I just...
Interesting. Take care then, Commander.
I don't wish to meet again. Wait.
Goodbye, Commander.
Oh. I forgot to ask. No. I'm going to keep it. Because I'm wondering now, where does I said no. You don't get experience requesting, do you? I can't recall if it's through just combat or through quests do you gain experience. Missions, I should say. But I want to keep it because I want to see what might happen. Since I didn't help her, if that have like a ramification. It couldn't. It probably won't, but you know, you never know. Where am I supposed to go? Prove the Citadel has gone rogue. Go to the Citadel Tower. Okay, there we go. Get Rex. They're allowing me to. Oh! Sorry. Sorry, folks. Sorry. Accidental discharge. Apologies. Sorry. Presidium locations. Citadel Tower. Transit in process. I remember back on the 360, this took like 3 minute loads. And then you'd have the loads in the elevator. And luckily they had conversations to kind of, you know, spin the wheels a bit. Ooh, go get Rex. I don't even know where he is. Oh, there's
Give
Garrus.
Me more time. Stall them.
Stall the council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
I was about to say, like, this is the start of the best friendship in video game history. My first response is, you blew it.
Sounds like you came up empty.
Saren's a specter. Most of his activities are classified. I couldn't find anything solid. But I know he's up to something. Like you humans say, I feel it in my gut.
I think the council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard.
Okay, give me Maybe one sec. I'm just going to run to the bathroom chat. I'll be right back. Okay. I'm back. So, let's take a look here. Fancy place. Man is low-key dodging. They're gonna give me more power. I'd like to say that's not a smart idea, Chad.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
So Saren's gonna attack us right out the gate.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I'm sorry.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre.
Is that Armin? Friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Is that Quark?
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me.
Or, if you want to be more accurate, would you kindly?
One who let the beacon get destroyed.
How did you get involved exactly, Saren? Why were you even in that territory?
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihlus gone, his files passed on to me. I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
Insults, typically, huh?
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor.
Arrogant.
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision.
Do we really want to bring that up?
May have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
Voines.
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
He looks so deflated. Aww. Sorry, buddy.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
And you know Saren because...
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here, but I know what he's like, and he has to be stopped.
Now what?
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Wait, that mission was the subject of the first novel? Oh.
He's a Turian. I don't want him on our side.
Not all Turians are like Saren. If he can help, we need to find him.
Hey, that's not the response that I was expecting to get.
Who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Cora's scolding.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
I thought you said he was a drunken loser.
Couldn't hurt to go talk to him. Just be careful. I wouldn't call him reliable.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
So, my understanding is Anderson was going to be a Spectre, right? He was supposed to be the first human to become a Spectre. Saren cock-locked him, right? I'm about to say something that just makes me as worse, if not worse, as Saren. And yet, how is Anderson going to, like, rationalize this statement? Right? Think about this.
Sometimes 1,000 people must die so 1,000,000 can live.
But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover